Dunner for a few seconds.
Well, hey, look what I got. I'm kind of proud of myself. I decided, you know, it's such a beautiful day. It just makes me want to go fishing, right? But I'm working here in the store, helping everybody that is going to go fishing. But, you know, the other day I decided I was going to cure up some kokanee corn. And it was actually Brad Schoenborn that suggested that I do this. So what we got here is just good white shoe peg corn that we sell here in the store. I should have grabbed a can, but the right stuff for corn. And it's the right stuff, I think, because it's really sweet, and that's what the fish really like, is sweetness. And it's kind of tough, and it's kind of the right shape. But what I did is mixed it up into a recipe that, you know, I've used quite a while. I know it's a really good, effective recipe. And man, does it smell good. It's kind of like a, it smells a little bit like corn on the cob and a tuna fish sandwich, you know? It's just, it does really smell good, like something you'd want to eat almost, but the kokanee would just go crazy over this. And it, because it's not so much, you know, especially in the winter time, the fish are a little lethargic. So whether you're using something like a, you know, Brad's cut plug or a kokanee, double whammy kokanee killer here with Max, or these little micro hoochies we got here from North Wild, little micro hoochie spinners, those are pretty cool. Or the wiggle hoochie that puts out a lot of action. It's not so much that the fish are trying to eat the lure. What they're trying to get is the corn that you put on the hooks or the maggots or whatever you have on your lure for bait. Not that kokanee at some point won't hit a lure, just out of aggression more or less. But they're trying to pick that corn off your lure. So the better your corn is, the more bite you're gonna get. So having really good corn is the way to go. And that's what's in here, is really good corn. So the way I cured this up, this particular batch, is start off with the Wizard corn dye, killer corn dye by Procure. That adds some good bite stimulants, it toughens it up a little bit, preserves it a little bit, and in this case with this one, makes it that bright pink color, which fish really like. Then I added some krill powder, which, you know, any kind of a fish loves krill. This is just a good staple for all kinds of fish, and kokanee really like this krill powder. And then I put in some, my Scent Chamber Magic Bloody Tuna, which is made with the Procure water soluble bloody tuna. So you know, regular oil will float to the surface, but the water soluble mixes down in there and absorbs into the corn really well. And it's just a really awesome scent to use with the corn. But there's also real blood in here, which is a very powerful scent to the fish, and an accelerant, which makes everything more powerful. It breaks down the molecules to where a fish can smell and taste it even more strongly than it's in the natural state. And I learned a little trick about the accelerator from somebody, I'll go ahead and tell you, from Gary Coe, who in fact was just inducted into the California Outdoor Hall of Fame a few weeks ago. And Gary was doing something to his baits one time, a long time ago, when I was filming with him. And he explained the concept to me. And I promised I'd never tell anybody, you know, because he's a competitive kokanee fisherman. But it makes stuff smell and taste stronger to the fish. And that's what's in here. So we've got this kokanee corn in the shop now. It's $2 a container. It's kind of a convenience for you. You can definitely buy a can of corn. We have corn here in the shop too, and all the different components to make up your own. Or you can just swing by if you're just doing a day of fishing, you know, a container like this will get you through the day, and you guarantee you the fish will love this stuff. And you know, maybe next week we'll do, you know, I could do the orange and some natural. I suppose when there's more people kokanee fishing, I'm gonna sell more. In fact, I sold some already before I even had it out to you know, promoter. Anybody knew about it, I already sold some. But you can come in the shop here this week and grab this. Now this is fresh corn, it's not gonna last. I mean, anything that's not sold by Saturday afternoon is gonna get tossed, and we'll do a fresh batch next week. So this isn't cured to where it's gonna last at all for more than 4 or 5 days probably. But you keep it cold, it'll last 4 or 5 days. But next week we'll brew up some other colors, see what people are interested in. It's always good to have a little variety. You know, like Vera Merwin, orange has been really good, and orange lures, like I've done really well on this kind of a hoochie there, like that wiggle hoochie, that orange, and this super bait, it's an orange super bait. You know, don't know. What do you guys comment down below about what color's been working for you? But I like orange on Merwin. I don't know. What do you guys think about that? So be sure to subscribe to the channel. We'll have more videos for you. And come on here to shop and give this little Kokanee corn a try. And let me know what you think. All right. So good luck fishing.